Hi, how are you? My name is Pilar. The name of this channel is Pilar Católico, which means Catholic Pilar. And today we will talk about pride, about arrogance. In which context? Well, we are in Lent. We are doing the most important time of the year. And you know what? In a lot of parishes, a lot of priests are offering the sacrament of the confession, of the reconciliation, that we can go to confess our sins, that we can clean up our hearts, that we can clean up our minds, that we can clean up all inside of us. I made a lot of mistakes during my life, and I went to several confessions. And I confessed my sins to a priest. So the priest absolved me for my sins and everything. But still, in my heart, I was continue feeling sorry. I was continue feeling repent of all the damage that I could make in somebody's heart. And I used to go again to another confession and confess the same mistake that I made. And again, I confess the same. And again, I confess the same. And maybe you think I'm silly. But what happened there is that I didn't forgive myself about the things I made. I just for the record, I didn't kill anybody. But I made mistakes. So what happened to me is this: in Poland, in Krakow, during the Warrior Day in Krakow in 2016, I made a very good confession with a priest there, because I was thinking, I will not see this priest again in my life, so I can tell him, simply tell him everything. And I told him, I already confessed this, but actually I do not believe that God can forgive me for this, because maybe it's my culture that we feel so sorry for everything all the time. I don't know. Maybe it's the way I was raised. So he told me something. You can put all together all your the sins that you told me, and it's not even this size in comparison with your pride, with your arrogance. Uy, in that moment I was like, ah, what? What? You saw me crying for all my sins, and you told me that all my sins are nothing in comparison with my pride? And he told me, yes, and you are listening to the devil more than God. In that moment, my tears come like, you know, I cry and say, no, I am Catholic, really, I'm Catholic. I love to be Catholic. I believe in Jesus Christ. I love him, really, I'm here for him. I pray the rosary, I pray. I am a Catholic YouTuber, really, how can you dare that I listen more to that? Really, I was, you see my pride there? Yes. And he told me, I will explain why I'm telling you these things. Well, you know what? When you go to confession, and you make a good confession, and you tell all your sins, all the mistakes that you made, and the priest already forgive you and absolve from all your mistakes, God is forgiving you. God is watching that you are really sorry for what you make. He knows that you cannot lie to God about what you make. He knows exactly if you feel sorry. He knows if you repent of all your sins. He knows it. He knows your heart. He knows your soul. He knows everything from you. He knows also if you go to confession and you don't confess everything, because maybe you're ashamed of something. He knows it. But if you confess the same over and over and over again, you are telling God, really, God, I don't believe that you can forgive me. I was thinking that God was not so wise enough to know all about me. You know what I mean? And then he told me something. If you continue mourning, and if you continue being sorry for these things, you're telling God, no, God, you know what? You are not so big in love enough to forgive me. You know what, God? I know more about my sins than you. And what I made cannot be solved. because you are not strong enough to solve everything, God. So I will continue mourning, so I will continue being sorry, so I will continue maybe hurting myself, hurting my soul, because I don't believe that you are powerful enough, God. You know what? In moments when you cry and you hear a voice that is telling you, you made this mistake, you make all these mistakes, and see how many people you damaged, and see how bad you are, see how many mistakes you made. God will not forgive you for this. Who is talking to you in that moment is the devil. And I was like, ah, what? Yes, it's the devil who is talking to you. That is telling you, God is not powerful enough to heal your heart. God is not powerful enough to forgive you. It's a lie. Jesus came to the earth and his sacrifice doesn't worth anything. Everything that you say in the church that you believe in his sacrifice for the forgiveness of sins, it's a lie. And you are believing that. In that moment, wow, I realized, wow. Doesn't mean that you must stop to feel sorry for the mistakes you made or the people that you could damage. But it means that you must accept that God already forgave you. Of course, if you made a good confession, take the chance of this Lent to make a good confession. Not too long, but a good confession. If you are ashamed that somebody, that the priest will know too much about you, go to other parish and talk to a different priest, so he will not know that who you are. So you go to a different, maybe that's what I will do. Because already the priest, of course, you know my English, the priest knows I am the only Latina. So go to other parish and clean yourself and believe that God will forgive you. But you must make a confession, but honest, truth. You don't have to give each details of your sins, but you must tell the sin. Well, I don't know which sins you have and which sins you have to confess, but try to make a good confession and believe that God will forgive you. Of course, this is very hard for me because I'm very superb in these things. Because sometimes I think, God, really, are you sure you can forgive this? And God, and that is something that I have to tell, okay, God is forgiving me, God is forgiving me, God forgave me, God has power, and God loves me that much that he's forgiving me. So, but sometimes I still have that little thing. I must close my ears to the devil that is telling me that God is not powerful and not and that God doesn't love me enough to forgive me and to love me again. I don't know if this happens to you. God can forgive you and will forgive you. Really, he loves you a lot. He knows your mistakes. He knows that you regret. He knows that you repent. He knows your pain, your sorrow. He knows it. So he can forgive you for real. Well, that's it. I hope you like this video. So take the chance this Lent and go to make a good confession and try to solve the damage. And if you already made all this, move on. Move on, change, and tell others that God can forgive them too. I will see you the next week. Bye.